हाय हेलो, गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन।
गुड
इवनिंग सर।
गुड इवनिंग, गुड इवनिंग कनिष्का,
गुड
अखिल,
इवनिंग
गुड
सर।
इवनिंग। सो हियर वी आर इन द न्यू नॉर्मल, कन्वर्सिंग विद ईच अदर डिजिटली थैंक्स टू सम ऑफ द एप्लीकेशंस लाइक जूम, दैट इट इज पॉसिबल फॉर अस टू डू सो। सम ऑफ यू इन दिस सेशन are new and some of you have been doing things the past 1 week. I hope the subject which is being taught to you is very crystal clear till now.
Yes,
Yes,
sir.
okay, now we begin. See, good evening everyone who've just joined, and the agenda for today's session will be a trip to UPSC Civil Services Examination, what it is, the syllabus, we will be dealing with it in detail, and what are the approaches to this examination, how will you deal with the syllabus, how will you study, how will you plan your studies, and how will you execute it. What role Elite IAS will play in your journey, we will be explaining all that. And then in the end, I will be taking up questions from you. And I would expect that the questions are relevant. One question has come up to me right away. Sir, anything about physical classes? I will be dealing with it in the end of the session. So to begin with, I will be sharing the screen with you. And we will be going through a PowerPoint presentation for the same. If anyone who feels uncomfortable or there is any lag in the network, you can feel free to send a message. Is that clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, civil services examination is basically said to be one of the toughest examinations in India. Why it is said to be the toughest examination? Because it involves a lot of studying, a lot of reading. You have to retain what you study. You have to build up an analytical bent of mind when you study. You have to develop answer writing skills for writing the answers. And in the end, you have to, develop a personality which will be tested in the interview so that they find you well enough or they find you good enough for being a civil servant. Okay. Now, all this, your journey basically should start with why. Why do you want to do this? Okay. Uday sir in the first class mentioned one thing, that the difference between those who get selected and those who don't is the clarity of thought. They know why they want to do it and how they want to do it. Okay. So this is one thing which is expected from you right from the very beginning. And that is why it was taught to you in the first class. And today also I am repeating the same thing. And if something is being repeated, you should understand the degree of its importance. Okay, now I would want you to answer me, why would you want to go for civil services as a career? Why do you want to become a civil servant as a career? I want your answers in the message column. There is no right or wrong in this. It is up to you what you think, why do you want to become this? Okay, so your answers are most invited in the message column. Request you to please send them. Why do you want to become a civil servant? Priya Bansal. Okay, one answer for the question that why I want to be a civil servant is it is my dream and my family's wish, and also can serve the nation for the betterment of every individual of our society is another. To serve the country, plus it suits my personal traits. Okay, I want to be respected wherever I go. It is, you know, there is a lot of, but a high degree of status attached with the service. Want to be part of a body which directly influences policy making to serve the country, and I would like to take it as my way of life. My childhood dream. Man, I need all the students to do brainstorming at least on this question, that why do you want to become a civil servant? It is the first question which you should ask to yourself. Whether you love the service, whether you love your nation, whether you know you want to serve the society. Everyone can have their own reasons, and no one is right or wrong in this. Okay, but you should be very clear in your mind that you want to do this for a particular reason, and that reason is this. It should be very convincing. Yes, Srinivas, why do you want to become a civil servant?
To serve the people, poor, sir. To serve the poor and to the service, serve to the nation in various sectors without any expectations.
Okay. Manas Kumar Jha has written a very elaborate answer. That is impressive. So we have got various answers. Some of the common answers is to serve the society. Few of them were their childhood dreams. Some, like someone's parents want them to become an IAS officer, and thus it has become their dream. What I want to say here is that everyone has his or her own reasons for becoming. Okay. My only point is that you should stick to it. You should stick to it. You should give it a thought in the beginning, whatever thought you want to give, and for how much ever time you want to give. Once you are very clear on that why do you want to be, you should be very clear. You should stick to it throughout your journey, because your journey might, you know, witness failures. Your journey might witness successes at times, and eventually you may succeed. But when you witness failures, then you should remind yourself that why did you choose this as a career path? Okay, am I clear, everybody?
Yes,
now, my second question is that how will you do it? That is the main question, that how to approach this examination? What all is there in this examination? So the first step of every aspirant is to think, why do you want to do it? The second step is how, and in that step you should primarily know the exam pattern, the syllabus. Know your syllabus is one thing which should be there with you throughout the journey, right from day one till day end. You should know what all parts are of your syllabus. It will help you on two fronts. Now, knowing the syllabus and pattern of civil services examination is the first step towards preparation. It will let you know three things. First thing is that it will help you plan your entire syllabus diligently. You will always be knowing what is done, what is left. Second is, in newspaper reading, it will help you. It will let you know what to read, what not to read, because only those topics are to be read which are part of your syllabus, and nothing more than that. Okay, and newspaper reading is something which has to be done daily. I'll be coming on that also later in my presentation. Okay. And thirdly, it will also enable you, or it will also empower you, to point a finger at us, that is elite IAS, that you did not cover this part of the syllabus. You will only be able to do so if you know the syllabus well, the entire syllabus. Now, in today's email which we sent you, the invitation link, we attached the detailed syllabus. There were two slides, two PowerPoint, two PDFs in that. One was the structure and the other was the detailed syllabus. I request everyone to go through that thoroughly, at least 20 to 25 times. I will be discussing the pattern here. But the detailed syllabus you have to read, which has been sent to you via email today. Okay. And by the end of this week, we will be discussing newspaper reading, how to read the newspaper. I will be taking up another session in that we will be discussing how to read the newspaper. Okay, is that fine? Has everyone received that email in which
the syllabus
was attached?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you have to go through that syllabus at least 20 to 25 times unless it is concretized in your head. I'm not saying that you have to mug it up thoroughly, but when you see a news in the newspaper, you should know that this is part of my syllabus and this is not. At least that level should be achieved for the syllabus part. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, yes, sir. Coming to the exam pattern, the exam pattern was revised in 2013 and it remains the same till date. Okay. Now there are three stages of the examination. The first stage is preliminary stage. Second stage is main stage. And the third stage is personality test. To give you a rough estimate, roughly 4 to 5 lakh people sit in the preliminary examination. They appear for the preliminary examination every year. 10 to 15,000 people clear the preliminary examination and go and write the mains examination. And around 3,000 people appear for the personality test. Final selection is somewhere in 800 to 1,000 years. Okay. It is very baseless to assume that the number of seats will go down next year or it will go up. You just have to focus on one seat that you have to take. That is it. The competition is stiff, no doubt, but you just have to focus on one seat. You have to keep yourself motivated throughout the journey. Now, in the preliminary stage, there are two papers, paper one and paper two. Paper one is of general studies. It is of 200 marks. 100 questions are asked, 2 marks for each question, and negative marking is 1/3, that is 0.66. Topics on which the questions are asked are history. In history, there are 4 subtopics: ancient history, medieval history, modern history, art and culture. Second subject is geography. Third subject is science. In this, general science is there and science and technology is also there. Next is ecology and environment. After that, polity, economics, and current affairs. Current affairs basically are based on these all the topics: science, ecology, environment, polity, economics. Let's suppose the parliament has passed a new bill. They may ask the provisions of that bill. That question will be said to be part of current affairs, but that current affairs is linked with polity. If a new invention is there, or let's suppose if ISRO has launched a new program, then you study about the space programs in science and technology. But since it is a recent news, it is a current news, people will say that it is part of current affairs, but that question is linked with current affairs, science and technology. So this is how UPSC asks questions. Speaking about the trend, this year, there were a lot of questions on agriculture. Agriculture basically is part of science, ecology, environment, and geography. All the three. Okay. Now, paper two is CSAT, Civil Services Aptitude Test is the full form. It is again of 200 marks. But the number of questions here are 80, 2.5 marks for each question, and negative marking is 0.84, 1/3 of 2.5. This paper is qualifying in nature. Qualifying means you have to score 33% marks, that is 66.66 marks out of 200 in order to get qualified. And if you qualify this paper, then only paper one will get evaluated. And how much ever marks you score in CSAT paper will not be counted in evaluating your merit. Okay. I hope this point is clear to everyone, that qualified nature of
CSAT.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Topics in this paper will be comprehension, mental ability, interpersonal skills, data interpretation, basic numeracy, and logical reasoning. The level of toughness is not so high. It is way below CAT, MAT. Okay. For previous year question papers, you can go to UPSC's website and download the previous year question papers for GS and CSAT both. GS paper is tough. CSAT is not. I was talking about CSAT only. The level of toughness is not so high. Okay. Now, speaking about the cutoffs for preliminary state for the past 4 years. Okay. 2015, I'll start. 2015, the cutoff was 107 out of 200. Since the marks in general studies papers will only be counted, the cutoff I'm mentioning is out of 200 for general studies only. Okay. 107 in 2015, 116 in 2016, 105 in 2017, 98 in 2018, and 98 in 2019. Okay. This is the cutoff which was for general studies, general category candidate. Okay. For other category students like OBCs, scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, physically disabled, the cutoff was below the cutoff which I mentioned, that is 105, 116, 107, 98. This is for general category only. Okay. Now, every year the cutoff is fluctuating. In 2015, it was 107, then it got up to 116 in 2016. Then it came down to 105. Then again, it came down to 98. So there are three reasons for this, for the fluctuation of cutoff. First is the level of toughness. Okay. More tough the paper will be, lower will be the cutoff. Second is performance of the students. Okay. And the third is vacancy with them. How, rolled out a vacancy of more people, then they'll be taking more people for the main stage. And thus the cutoff will be lower then. Okay. In 2016, when the cutoff shot up from as compared to 2015, there were around 70 to 80 questions from current affairs only. Polity had one or two questions. History had two questions. Okay. The paper was very much skewed towards current affairs. Now, this is how UPSC will throw bouncers at you. It has not mentioned that how many questions will it be asking from which section. It can ask any number of questions from any sections. Point to be noted here is that you have to prepare yourself wholly for the preliminary stage. In the preliminary stage, they are asking questions from those topics which are not specifically part of preliminary stage. For example, international relations. They're asking a lot of questions. You pick up the question paper of prelims for the last 3-4 years, you will find a lot of questions from international relations in the preliminary paper. International relations is nowhere mentioned in the preliminary section. But someone filed an RTI in UPSC that why are you asking questions from international relations and preliminary examination? So UPSC replied in a very crisp way. They said that we are asking questions based on current events. We have never mentioned that we will be asking questions on current events of India only. We are asking of current events of the world. That is why that is not a part of international relations. That question is part of current affairs. Okay. So what I mean to say is that while going for the preliminary examination, you have to be prepared for mains also. Okay. Before 2013, the gap between prelims and mains was somewhere around 5 to 6 months. But now that gap has been reduced to 2.5 months. Okay. If you're not well prepared for mains also before prelims, then there's no point of going. Okay. So holistically prepare yourself, then only your this attempt will be impactful. Okay. Everyone clear on this preliminary stage?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, next is the main stage where roughly 10 to 15,000 students reach. This again is a very tiring stage. You need physical strength as well as mental strength to crack this stage. In a day, there will be two examinations of 3 hours each. And next day also, you'll be having two examinations. After that also, you'll be having two examinations on the trot. So like 4 to 5 days on the trot, you'll be writing exams. Okay. There'll be no time to revise during the examination. Last year only, UPSC gave a gap of around 5 to 6 days for optional paper. Else, they've never given such gaps in this examination. Okay. So you need to prepare yourself. You need to practice so hard that you are able to, you know, match the requirement on the day of examination. Okay. Now, in the main stage, there are 9 papers in total. These all are subjective. Okay. There's no point of negative marking here since it is subjective. People say that in main stage also negative marking is there, but actually it is not there. We have confirmed it from sources who are evaluating the UPSC paper that no such negative marking funda is there. They are professors of various eminent universities like Jawaharlal Nehru University and Delhi University, the evaluators basically. Okay. Now in this main stage, there are 9 papers out of which 2 are qualifying. Okay. The 2 qualifying papers, the first is English. Okay. And the second is a language paper. English paper is of 300 marks. Similarly, the language paper, language is one of the languages which you have to choose from the 8 schedule of the constitution. It contains 22 languages. English is not part of that. Hindi is there, Marathi is there, Gujarati, Konkani, Nepali is also there, Bengali, Punjabi, Malayalam. There are, you can go through the list, you can Google it. 22 languages are there. People from South India can write this exam in their mother language. People from North India basically take Hindi, nothing more than that. Okay. So these both the papers are of 300 marks each. And you have to score minimum of 25%. That is 75 marks in each of the papers. Okay. If you score minimum of 75, that is if you score more than 75 in both the papers, then only the rest of the papers will get evaluated. Else you will not qualify and the rest of the papers will not get evaluated. These papers per se are easy, very easy. Again, you can go to UPSC's website and download the previous year question papers, but you cannot take them lightly. In these papers, like for example, in the English compulsory paper, you will be asked to write an essay of around 600 words. Then there will be a section of pressy writing in which you will be given an article and you have to sum up that article in 1/3 of the words. There will be boxes and in one box you'll have to write one word and the words will be counted. You have to sum up the entire article in those words. Then you have a section on grammar and the 4th section will be reading comprehension in the English paper. These 4 sections will be there. In the language paper, these 4 sections will be there, like for example, such as essay writing, pressy writing, grammar and reading comprehension. Apart from that, translations from that particular language to English, this section will be added. So 300 marks each and you have to score a minimum of 75 in each paper. Okay. I have seen students failing in these papers. So do not take these papers lightly, although they are very easy. You can see the previous year question papers. You can download them from UPSC's website and you can have a look at them. Next is General Studies paper 1. Now, one disclaimer which I'd like to give here is, like in prelims, the General Studies, sections, all these sections are part of mains also. Like history, ancient, medieval, modern, art and culture will be part of mains also. Geography will also be part of mains. And in mains, some additional things are there, which we will be discussing here. Like history of India. History of India includes ancient, medieval, modern, art and culture, including post-independence history. Now, this is something new which has been added in mains. Post-independence history is the history after 1947 till 2000. Okay. And the world history is added. This section is going on in your classes right now. We have started with world history. There is a reason why we started with world history. I'll let you know in further ahead in the presentation. Okay. So, General Studies Paper 1, the first section is History of India, including post-independence history and the world history. Second is Geography. It is part of prelims also. And next is Social Issues. Okay. Now, in this year prelims, there were around 4 questions from post-independence history. This part, which is part of mains. But they asked it in prelims. Okay, so need you to be aware on all these things, all these facts. Okay, General Studies Paper 2 comprises of Indian polity, governance, social justice, and international relations. Now, social justice and social issues are separate. Don't mix them up. Social issues is part of Paper 1 and social justice is part of Paper 2. Okay. Clear everyone till now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, General Studies Paper 3. This comprises of economics, science and technology, ecology and environment. All these three were part of prelims also.
Sir, economics kaun si aayi? Micro ya macro?
Macro. No micro in your syllabus. Only macroeconomics is part of your syllabus.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Internal security, disaster management. Okay. The number of subjects in GS paper 3 are the maximum, but they are, apart from economics, all these subjects are small. The syllabus for all these subjects is not so huge. Okay. General Studies paper 4 is ethics, integrity, and aptitude. This paper is basically divided into 2 sections. This paper was added, first of all, this paper was added in 2013, after 2013. Before 2013, it was not there. Okay. Basically, this paper is divided into 2 sections. In the first section, the concepts of ethics are taught to you. What is ethics, integrity, aptitude? Then you have basic concepts on emotional intelligence, corporate governance, and such like values and such like. 120 marks for the section 1. And section 2 is case studies. That is very interesting one. The second section. In that second section, they will be asking you questions in which they will be creating a situation for you and they will be asking you to solve that situation. For example, once they asked that suppose you are a district magistrate of an area, of a hilly area, and flash floods have occurred, a natural calamity has occurred. Okay. You have to evacuate people from that area. Okay. Now, there are 7 categories of people in front of you. Those 7 categories of people are women and children, elderlies, then a politician from the central ruling party who has come there with his family, tourists, mountain climbers, hikers, that is, then prisoners from the local prison, and an IAS officer of a senior rank, of a secretary level rank from the neighboring state who came there for his official visit. Okay, you have to devise a strategy sequence in which you will be evacuating these people and you have to give reasons why. Okay, now why I am taking up this example in between of this syllabus discussion, because I want to tell you one thing very clearly, that there is no one right answer for case studies in ethics. Okay, you think that, you know, let's suppose you think that elderly you'll send because they've lived their life. Okay. You send women and children earlier. Some other person might say that they'll be sending the elderly people earlier, just after women and children, because on humanitarian ground, it is our duty and it is also in our, you know, culture that we respect our elders and also we will be sending them earlier. So there are various viewpoints present there. There is nothing right or wrong in case studies. You just have to be very practical. You just have to be have to violate any laws or the constitution. Within these boundaries, you have to give a solution to them. Okay. So, okay. The next paper is essay. Out of four, you pick one and write. The second essay will also be having four options. Out of four, you pick one and write. Okay. Each essay should be of 1,000 to 1,200 words each. Okay. I request you to mute your session, please.
Sir, can you repeat about essays?
Whoever has joined. Okay. The essay paper comprises of two essays. Okay. They have to pick one and write. Then again, there will be four options. You have to pick one and write. Okay. Each essay should be of 1,000 to 1,200 words. Okay. Topics are very general, like economic issues, social issues, political issues. There will be essays on ethical issues. Then there will be statement based essays. Okay. Current based essays, like once they asked about the GST implementation right away. The year GST was implemented, that year there was a question on goods and services tax implementation. Okay. In 2015, APJ Abdul Kalam died. I request you to mute. Prabhakar, Gautam, please mute. Prabhakar, Gautam, please mute yourself. Thank you. Hello, am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
I was talking about the essays, the topics on which they are asking essays every year: economic issues, social issues, statement-based essays, current-based essays. Now, in 2015, APJ Abdul Kalam died. APJ Abdul Kalam's very famous quote is that dreams are not those which you see while sleeping. Dreams are those which don't let you sleep. Have you all heard about it?
Yes, sir.
That year, they asked a question in essay paper that dreams that can't let India sleep. Okay. So this is how they connect. In 2016, there was a tussle going on between Karnataka and Tamil Nadu regarding the Kaveri River. There were a lot of, violence also. So they straight away asked a question on interstate water dispute. Okay. So this is how they will be asking you questions in essay. We will be dealing with essays in the end, because essay requires a lot of dimensions. Okay. And all these dimensions are your subjects. Once you cover all these subjects, then go for essay writing, then it will be an impactful essay writing method. Okay. If you go for essay writing in the beginning, you will struggle a lot and you will get depressed and you'll leave essay. Essay will be something like you will be fearful of. Okay. But if you pick up essays in the end, after completing the entire syllabus, you will be gathering a lot of fodder with you to write, because you have to write essay in 1000 to 1200 words. That is why essay is picked up in the end. Okay, is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Now comes the optional subject. You have to choose one subject, and of that one subject, there will be two papers of 250 marks each. Okay. Optional subject is very much important. It is the game changer. Why it is the game changer? See, lot of students, around 4 to 5 lakh students are appearing in preliminary stage. 15,000 students are coming to the main stage. Okay. And on the basis of general studies. Okay. Because they are getting sieved on the basis of general studies only. So general studies of those 15,000 students are cut to cut strong. Okay. Not much difference is created in general studies papers. Like if I score 100, you might be scoring 95 out of 250. One might be scoring 105. Maximum 10-15 marks difference is there in general studies papers. Okay. The main difference comes in the optional paper and a bit in essay paper also, but mainly the difference in marks comes in the optional paper. And since you are appearing in a competitive examination, the only thing which matters is the difference in marks between your marks and the competitor's marks. Okay. You should know which subject you are comfortable with. I will be dealing with how to choose an optional subject, but for here, you just need to know that optional subject is very important and is the game changer. Okay. Now, factors to be considered for choosing the optional subject. Okay. The first and foremost factor is interest, and it is the most important one. How will you identify where your interest lies? It is very easy for me to say that whichever subject interests you, you take that subject. But how to identify your interest? Because most of the students are confused that which subject I am interested in. Okay. Some go with the peers. Some see the fancy name of the subject. Oh, psychology, I'll be taking that. Some see philosophy intriguing. Some see sociology intriguing. But to identify your interest, you should go through the syllabus of that particular subject. You should also go through previous year question papers. That might not help a lot, previous year question papers, because if you don't have any idea about the subject, then only the subject syllabus will help you. And you can wait and keep doing general studies. Okay. If you keep doing general studies, then you will be able to identify with time that where your inclination lies towards more. Let's suppose social issues or social justice intrigues you more, then this means that you should go for sociology. Okay. If polity intrigues you more, then you should go for political science or public administration. Okay. So this is how you will identify your interest. So those people who are still confused that which optional subject I should choose, they should wait as of now. Okay. And keep doing general studies. With time, they will identify, they will grow, they will mature also, and they can identify easily after a period of time. Second factor is success rate. You know, every subject has its own success rate. You will find the success rate report in the 67th annual report by UPSC. It is available on UPSC's website. I request everyone to visit UPSC's website and download that report. Do not go to any coaching institute's website and take that report. That report might be manipulated. Okay. But go to UPSC's website, download that report. In that report, there is a table in which it is given that from which optional subject, how many students appeared, how many cleared, and what is the success rate. Okay. So this will give you a glimpse into the level of competition for that particular subject. Okay. The third factor for choosing an optional subject is utility in general studies. what will be its utility in general studies. You study for that particular subject, you don't need to revise for this thing, general studies. Like for example, sociology has immense utility in general studies. Like there's an essay on social issues every year, social issues, social justice, you'll not need to study separately. Sociology will also be helping you in paper 3 and paper 4. So this is how you can gauge the utility of that particular optional subject in GS. This is something where you can play smart, okay, and reduce the burden on you, because there'll be immense burden on you. The fourth factor for choosing an optional subject is your educational background. Okay. Let's suppose you've done a degree in mechanical engineering and you were very sound in that. Okay. And you've done it from a very reputed college. You have good grasp over the concepts of all the 4 years of mechanical engineering. Then you can go for mechanical engineering. You can leave aside everything, interest, society, utility in GS. Sumit, I request you to mute yourself. Thank you. Okay, so these are all the factors which you should consider before choosing an optional subject. Make an informed decision. Okay, do not make an uninformed decision, or do not, you know, just make a decision. Okay, because since optional is the game changer, it might take you in the wrong way or it might take you in the right way. But a well thought decision has more chances of taking you in the right way. Okay, am I clear, everybody?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, the next level, we've dealt with the prelims level, we've dealt with the mains. Now comes the next stage, that is personality test. Anjali Kumari, please mute yourself. Thank you. The personality test, people also call it the interview. Okay. You might have heard a lot of stories about IAS interview. You might have seen a lot of videos on social media for this IAS interview. Okay. Not all of them are wrong, but yeah, I would say that some of them give the wrong information. Okay. Now, in the personality test, your knowledge is not being tested. This make this thing very clear. They have tested your knowledge in the preliminary stage and the mains stage. Okay. The main test is how you present that knowledge. The manner in which the acquired knowledge is put to use, it is a test of that. Okay. It is a test of your temperament and it is a test of your integrity. Okay. Like I'll give you certain examples, you'll connect better. I have one of my friends who is presently serving in IRS. He was asked around 16 questions in the interview, and for out of 16 questions, 12 he answered that, sir, I don't know, I'm not so sure about it. Okay. And 4 questions he answered very articulately, very clearly, and he was very firm on it. The interviewers tried to, you know, entangle him, but he was very clear on that. So he answered it and he was very firm on his stand. But 12 questions he did not answer.
Sir, your voice clear.
And he scored 200.
Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Hello. I was saying that my friend answered 4 out of 16 questions which he was asked in the interview. And he scored 221 marks out of 275. And this is one of the highest which I have ever heard. Okay. So what we concluded from this was that it is not a test of your knowledge. It is a test of how you present your knowledge, whatever you have. One of the very famous, you know, times, Aristotle said that knowledge is knowing what you don't know. The true knowledge is knowing what you don't know. And if you clearly, if you are vocal about what you don't know, you should have more chances of getting succeeded. In preliminary stage also, if you are clear that you don't know, you will not answer that question. You will.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir, it's you.
Yes, is it clear now?
Yes, yes.
Okay. So I was on the personality test. You should know what you don't know, and you should be vocal about it. It's okay. You cannot know everything, and this should be a T. Okay. Second is temperament. Okay. They will be instigating you, you know, to answer. Like, for example, the Babri Masjid. Is the screen visible to you? Personality test?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Chalo. So, the second point I was discussing, temperament. The interviewers will try to instigate you. They will try to take out your internal thoughts. I was asked about this question when I was appearing in 2015 interview, that what do you think about the Babri Masjid demolition case? Okay, what are your views about that? Okay, and earlier they asked, they knew about my religion and all. So simply over there, you have to play safe because they are taking you for this thing. A bureaucracy, and bureaucrats have to be neutral. They have to be, you know, they have to be impartial. Okay. The simple answer for that, which I gave, was, sir, the matter is sub judice. Whatever the court gives as the judgment, it will be my duty as a future civil servant to obey that. Okay. You can play safe, and this will only come if you have a balanced temperament. Okay, if you are instigated by these type of, you know, questions, they, it will not work in your favor at all. It will never. Okay, and the third point, your integrity is being tested. Integrity is basically the integration of your thoughts, the integration of your actions, and the integration of your words. Okay, integration of thoughts, words, and actions. It should be in sync. It should not be like you are thinking something else and you are speaking something else. You will fumble and they will definitely catch you, and it will again not work in your favor. Okay. So everyone clear on the personality test point? Interview, yes, point?
Yes.
So can you repeat for integrity?
Integrity is basically the integration of your thought, your action, and your words. Okay. If you are not integral, like you are thinking something else and you are speaking something else, you will fumble and they will catch you. Okay.
Okay.
It should come from within. Okay. And this should be a very integral part of your personality, this integrity. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Now, we will be dealing with the personality test section with you guys if you clear your mains. That is all part of your package. Okay. But only after clearing the mains. Okay. There will be mock interviews. There will be DAF analysis. DAF is basically detailed application form. It is a form which is filled by the candidates after clearing prelims. That is a 10-page form, very exhaustive form. And it contains every information, each and every information about you. Okay. It will entail your hobbies. What does your father do? What does your mother do? Their income, your past experiences, your past professional experiences, your achievements, everything will be there. And each and every interviewer will be having the detailed application form in front of them. Okay. So you, we will be helping you out in filling up that form, and once you clear your mains, we will be conducting mock interview sessions with retired bureaucrats and the serving bureaucrats, and we will also be doing DAF analysis prior to the mock interview for you. Okay, so now what does Elite IAS have for you? Now, one thing I'd like to make clear to all of you here is that some of you are part of the offline program, some of you are part of the online program. Okay, the ones who are part of the offline program, they have begun their course with the online program, and that is completely convertible to the offline mode. We have begun the live courses in order to save your time. Okay, those all who have registered for offline program, do not worry at all. As soon as the government allows us to open the premises and conduct teaching there, we will be notifying each and every one of you, and you can come and join the offline program. Your course fees, your course which have been covered, which will all be adjusted there. Okay, in the offline program, you can repeat also the sections which you have done in the online mode. That is not an issue. Okay, we've just begun this online mode to save your time and included you here. Okay, so in the offline program, the foundation course covers GS prelims, CSAT, GS mains, all the papers, essay. Optional will depend on the type of course you take. In all the courses, optional is not there. GS integrated, optional is not included. Upgraded foundation course, optional is included. Okay, and all India test series for prelims, mains, essay and optionals is also there. Okay, in the online course, those people who have specifically registered themselves for the online course, we are giving you GS prelims, CSAT, GS mains, essay, that is all the sections of general studies. Optional classes, if you want to take, that will be separate. Okay, and all India test series is not there, that can be taken separately. Okay, is that clear to everyone, the online course students and the offline course students, and the convertibility part?
Yes sir.
Okay, only three people are clear about it.
Yes sir.
Sir, can you repeat it once more, sir?
Okay, may I know your name, please? Hello, who wants it?
Kishore, sir. Kishore.
Kishore, we have two courses. Okay, first is offline course. Okay, since we are not allowed to run the academy presently, the government has restricted us due to the coronavirus pandemic. We have taken admissions for offline, but we have started the course in online mode for those people who have taken admission in offline mode. Their course will be completely convertible once we are allowed to open. Okay, their fees will be adjusted there, their course will be adjusted there in the offline mode. It is just done to save the time. Okay, and
okay sir.
The second is the online course. Those people who are specifically registered for the online course, they will not be coming for the offline is here. However, if any student who has registered him or herself for online course and later wants to convert himself or herself to the offline course, that can be done after having a word with the management. That also will be done. Okay, what I mean to say in short is that the online course is completely convertible to the offline course once we reopen. Okay sir, am I clear, Kishore, to you?
Okay sir.
Okay, now from here on I am going to discuss the approaches to the examination, and this is very important. This has nothing to do with the syllabus. These are something which is very general but very important for everyone. So the approaches to the examination. Okay. The first approach is good planning and execution. You have seen the, you know, structure of the examination. You have seen how many subjects you have to study. Roughly, if I speak, 18 subjects in general studies, one subject is CSAT, 19, and the 20th subject is your optional subject. Okay. So 20 subjects you have to study. A lot of books are there. Okay. If you do not plan it well and you do not execute it well, you are not going to be there in the list. This is very clear. I am extremely sorry for being very clear and blunt, but if you do not have a good plan at your disposal and good execution skills, you are not meant for the job. You know, bureaucrats basically are executives to the government. Those are permanent executives. Their role is to execute the plans, policies, and laws made by the government. In this year prelims, there was a question on role of bureaucrat, and this was the right answer. Execution of plans, policies, and laws by the government. Okay. So UPSC is looking for those people who are good planners and executioners. In the earlier stages of your service as a bureaucrat, you will solely be focusing on execution of plans, policies, and laws. In the later years of your services, when you reach higher ranks, you will be sitting in the ministries and you will be making those plans, policies, and laws. So if you are good at planning and execution, you are meant for this examination. The vastness of the syllabus also requires you to be a good planner and executioner. Okay. We will be helping you with the planning part. There can be two sections of, you know, two categories of students. The first category of students is those who are only studying. They have completed their graduation. They are not working anywhere. They are solely preparing for this examination. The plan for these type of students will be different. Second category of students, those who are college going or those who are working and side by side they are preparing, plan for these kind of people will be different. Okay. And we will be making it the tailor made for you. You can contact us later for planning. Okay. You can give us your requests on our email ID. All those who want their plan to be made. So the students of Elite IAS will also be availing this facility of planning, and execution will be your prerogative. Any problem you find in execution, you let us know. We will give you a solution. Okay. The planning part is ours. And if any problem comes while executing the plan, then solving that problem is ours, our prerogative. Okay. But coming up with the problems and requesting for planning is your prerogative. Okay. Am I clearly audible now, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Chalo. So understood good planning and execution part?
Yes, sir.
Now, the second approach to this examination is revision maximization. Okay. A lot of students ask, sir, what to read, what not to read. There are a lot of books to read. And, you know, they are also living in this fancy world that they are preparing for this IAS or UPSC. And due to this, they collect a lot of books and they make a library in their room or their home. Okay. Visitors come to their room or their home and they see that this person has created a library for himself or herself. He is a very intellectual person or something like that. I would like to make one thing very clear here is that do not collect books. By collecting books or even by reading them, you are not going to get into the services. You have to take books, limited number of books. The teachers will be telling you here. We will be telling you. Those are standard sources. And you have to read them again and again. You have to maximize the revisions of those particular books only. And mind you one thing, that even for the 10th time, if you are reading that particular book, you will find something new. Okay. UPSC delves on this. UPSC asks questions on the basis of this. Like this year in the prelims examination, UPSC had asked 3 to 4 questions on very minute details. Like which of these following are mentioned in the constitution? Okay, and given were like three options were judgments, but aspirants generally feel that these are mentioned in the constitutions, but those are Supreme Court judgments. This will only get clear if you do revision maximization. Okay, whether it is mentioned in the constitution or it is a judgment of the Supreme Court. If you do not maximize your revisions, these kind of minute details you will not come across and you will not have a grip over the syllabus. Okay, and revision maximization, for revision maximization, you need to plan well. Okay, like for example, world history is going on right now. You complete world history, then social issues will come, social justice will come, then international relations will come. As you progress in your syllabus in with us in the live classes, you will be completing the subjects like world history will be completed, social issues will start, then social justice will come. So when social justice comes, you have to take a revision loop of world history. Like for half an hour daily or 45 minutes daily, you have to revise world history, but all topics you have completed. So in this way, you have to plan your studies. We will be dealing with this for those who will be asking us to plan. Okay. We have to keep this in mind, revision maximization. Okay. Okay. So am I clear on this revision maximization wala approach, the second approach?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, the third is multidimensional approach. What do you mean by multidimensional approach? See, UPSC is not going to ask you straightforward questions. UPSC examination is not your school examination or your college examination. By college, I mean graduate or postgraduate. In graduation and in post-graduation, they ask very direct questions and you can answer them easily if you've studied. Here, they will be asking you analytical questions, multidimensional questions. Like last year mains, they asked a question that what is biotechnology and how can biotechnology help uplift the living standards of farmers? Okay, a living standard is something which comes in economics. Okay, standard of living. And biotechnology is something which comes in science and tech. Both are part of GS3. This question was asked in GS3. But you need to know how to connect biotechnology with standard of living of farmers, basically. Now, just to give you a brief idea, biotechnology has enabled, has invented BT cotton. BT stands for Bacillus thuringiensis. It is basically a biotechnologically manufactured breed of cotton in which you don't need to put pesticides while growing cotton. And the yield of cotton has grown immensely, somewhere around 4 to 5 fold before BT cotton was there. And since the yield has grown, biotechnology has enabled, upliftment of standard of living of farmers. Okay, so you need to connect this way. Okay, you just don't need to, study the concept in isolation. You need to connect. You need to be a thinking mind. Okay. And don't overthink also. Just basic connections should be there. Okay. And again, this will only be established. This multidimensional approach will only be developed if the revisions are maximized. If you do not maximize the revisions, you will not know the concepts clearly. Everything will be air. Everything will be jumbled up in your head. So you'll not be able to connect them. If you revise consistently, everything will get concretized in your head and establishing connections will be easy. Okay, so all these three things are interlinked: good planning and execution, revision maximization, multidimensional approach. The newspaper will be filled with multidimensional approach topics. Okay, so whenever I'll be taking, by the end of this week, I'll be taking the newspaper reading session for the students, and there I will be discussing that. I'll be showing you how multidimensional approach is coming into picture in a particular article or an editorial. Okay. Now, the fourth basically approach is, or the behavioral aspects of yours. Okay. It is not just studying. You have to develop yourself as a human being. You have to develop your basically your basic nature. Okay, and if you do not do this, you will be lacking on behavioral aspects of for bureaucrats. You will, without these behavioral aspects, you cannot clear the examination. This is one thing very straightforward, I'm telling you. Take care. The first behavioral aspect which you need to have in yourself is patience. I hope I do not need to explain why you need patience, because a lot of things have been said earlier. Okay. Things will take their time. Okay. Things will take their time. You just have to be consistent in your efforts. Okay. Things will not happen overnight. ऐसा नहीं होगा कि छड़ी घूमेगी और सब कुछ हो जाएगा. इट इज नॉट अ मैजिक वैंड. ओके, यू हैव टू पुट इन एफर्ट्स. ओके, वी विल बी देयर थ्रू आउट योर जर्नी, बट मेन एफर्ट्स विल बी योर्स. एनी कोचिंग इंस्टीट्यूट और एनी पर्सन हु सेज दैट आई विल डू इट फॉर यू, दे आर फूलिंग यू. यू हैव टू डू इट फॉर योरसेल्फ. वी विल बी शोइंग यू अ पाथ. यू हैव टू वॉक ऑन दैट पाथ. इफ यू फॉल व्हाइल वॉकिंग, we'll pick you up, and then again you have to walk then also. Okay, we are not the ones who have to walk. We will make you walk. Okay, but having patience is necessary. You should know that things will take time. Writing skill will take time to develop. We will ensure that from the beginning you start writing. Okay, second thing is consistency in your behavioral aspects. You might forget at times. It is very difficult to retain, but you should be very consistent in your efforts. You have to revise whatever you forget. You have to keep revising. You have to keep writing. Every Sunday there will be a test. You have to be consistent in giving the tests. Then only development will be there. Else it will not be there. And mind you one thing, everyone begins very nicely, but 1 month down the line or 2 months down the line, everyone is, most of the students, सबका जोश ठंडा हो जाता है. तो I do not want anyone to come here in elite IAS who will be the backing himself up or herself after 2 to 3 months. They are just completing the course and going. We want serious students and those students who can do it consistently for a longer period of time. हमें भी तभी मजा आएगा, ठीक है. The third aspect, behavioral aspect, is optimism. Optimism simply means positive thinking. It will not happen that in every Sunday test you will perform well. At times you might not perform well, but this does not mean that you stop giving the Sunday tests. You have to keep yourself in a positive frame of mind, and you should be happy enough that you got to know your mistakes before the examination. You have to see your poor performance in the mock tests as opportunities for you to improve. Okay. And that will only happen if you have an optimistic mindset. Okay. The next behavioral aspect which you need to have in yourself is avoid procrastination. Does anyone of you know the meaning of procrastination?
No, sir.
The one who knows, please let us know.
It's a thing that we do. For example, when we delay a thing for the next day or tomorrow, which is supposed to be done today, that is known as procrastination.
Yes. If something is planned for today, it has to be done today itself. You should not say that I'll do it tomorrow or I'll do it later, because doing this is the easiest thing. Okay, I'll do it later. But what happens is you'll start creating a mountain of things for yourself. Okay. And at the same time, your competitor is, if your competitor is doing it right now, then he is going ahead of you. And you are piling up a mountain for yourself for later. Okay. And when, you know, the time comes to clear that mountain of doubts or your procrastinated, efforts, it will be very difficult for you. It will be very difficult for you. So avoid this. ठीक है? You do not, आलस मत दिखाओ. अभी करो. ठीक है? You should be very much planned enough in yourself. Okay. The next aspect is enjoy the process. This is very difficult, but you know, those who do it, they achieve big things. I hope everyone knows MS Dhoni here. Mahendra Singh Dhoni.
Yes, sir.
You will find him very consistently or very frequently talking about the process. Okay. We were there to enjoy the process. We were there to go through the process. And he is one of the most successful captains of Indian cricket. Okay. Because he was there in the process. He presence of mind was there. He was living the moment during the process. He was not thinking of the future. And he did it well. And that is why he did well. Okay. Why I have put this point of enjoy the process is basically most of the aspirants, even some of you might be there. It might come to your mind that whenever I'll become an IAS officer or an IPS officer, I'll do this, I'll do that. Students go in this trap of daydreaming. Okay. And while doing this, they compromise on the present scenario, the present time. They keep thinking, they live in that fancy world of when I'll become, I'll do this, I'll do that. And they compromise on the present time when they have to study. Okay. So do not fall in that trap of daydreaming. Okay. And do not also fall in that trap of showing off. Okay. Which brings me to the next approach, that is avoid arrogance. There is a very famous saying that knowledge brings arrogance. Okay. In Hindi, gyan ahankar lekar aata hai. Okay. You will be learning so much that matlab everything under the sun is your syllabus. Literally everything under the sun is your syllabus. Okay. Anything happening around the world, you'll know about it after a certain point of time. But that should not, you know, lead to arrogance. I have seen a few students in front of me who were very good students throughout their journey, but arrogance crept in, and when arrogance crept in, their downfall started. They were not even able to be humble, be open to learn always, because learning is a never ending process. Okay. You develop this arrogance, you'll not get into the list. Okay. So am I clear on this behavioral aspects, everyone?
Yes, sir.
How will we tackle these approaches to the examination? We at Elite IAS, I have told you, it is very easy for me to tell. It is very easy for me to preach. But how will we tackling it? Okay. We will be helping you in answer writing and concept building through weekly tests. Okay. Consistency will be your prerogative. In giving the tests, consistency in conducting the tests will be our prerogative. Okay. The teachers will be evaluating this test and giving you feedback on that. Okay. Plan formulation is done at the start of your course, which I told you, that anyone who wants to get their plan formulated, they can write to us. We will be doing it for them. Newspaper reading session, I told you, I'll be doing it by the end of this week. So that by the time you get more familiarized with the syllabus part, okay, and then newspaper reading will be very essential, very beneficial for you. One thing I'd like to make very clear here is no one will be entering that newspaper reading session without having a considerable grip over the syllabus. Okay. And the next point is we will be regularly exposing you to our selected candidates. They will be coming on I have come for this online session, although I'm not selected. I am the head of academics here at Elite IAS. But selected candidates will be coming to you and taking up a session. They will be sharing their strategies. They will be telling you at what point of time you should do what. Okay. So we will be exposing you to them. Okay. Now, in the end, the success mantra which we give you is nothing is achieved overnight. You have to make consistent efforts for it. Okay. We here at Elite IAS will make sure that your efforts are made in the right direction so that you can achieve your dreams. Whenever you are going wrong or whenever you are facing any problem, it is you who should come to us. Okay. One thing I'd like to make very clear here is, if problems are coming in your way, this means that you are going in the right direction. Okay. If you are not going in the right direction, problems will not come. Or if you are not doing anything, then problems will not come. Problems will only come if you are making efforts in the right direction. And it is you who has to come up with your problems to us. And it is we who have to give a solution to your problems. The problems should not be personal. The problems should be related to the syllabus, should be related to the course, or should be related to the preparation. Okay, we will not be dealing with any personal stuff. I'm very clear, making you very clear on this. Okay, now I would like to invite questions. I have received some of the questions in the message section, which I'll be answering them first, and then I'll be moving ahead. So Anurag has asked, if graduation subject and optional subject matter or not? If these subjects are different, will they ask questions related on this issue? Yes, in the personality test, they may ask questions related on that issue, that you, why did you not take up that optional? Okay. A simple answer to that optional, that question can be that, sir, I am not proficient or I was not confident in that particular subject. I was much confident in this particular subject, which I took, and this intrigued me more. And by saying this, you will save yourself from the being asked questions on your graduation subject also, because they will come to know that you're not, proficient in that. Okay. Anjali Kumari has asked, is there history optional available? Anjali, not as of now, but we plan to introduce public administration, history, anthropology as optional subjects. Okay. An anonymous name has asked, how much time will you teach in offline course per day, sir? 2 hours per day, Monday to Friday. Okay, 2 to 2.5 hours per day, Monday to Friday. Largely, it will be 2 hours. Okay. Optional, kaun-kaun se hai? Is there history optional? I have already answered this question. Now, Anurag has asked, will the board ask questions over our graduation subject? Yes, it may ask. It may very well ask you questions over your graduation subject, but the questions will be very basic. There'll be no technical questions. Okay. Then someone has talked about the fees here, Tanishka. For the fees related issues, I request you to kindly coordinate with our counselors, Miss Monica and Mr. Rohit. They will be telling you clearly about that. This is not my domain. Okay. G. Kishore has asked, what about the books, sir? Now, whoever will be enrolling in our course, we will be sending them books, and we will also be telling you a set of books which you need to buy from outside. They will be very less though. Okay. When can we expect the offline classes? This question, the Delhi government can only give the answer to this question. We cannot give. It will depend on the cases of coronavirus, the spread of coronavirus. Whenever they give us instructions to open, we will be opening. We will be notifying everyone. Okay. Since I am not the part of the government, so it will be very difficult for me to answer the question. Okay. Venkat Siva has asked, duration of the course, it will be roughly 1 year, 11 months to 12 months. Okay. Sir, is it a myth or truth that a UPSC aspirant should study 8 to 10 hours regularly? See, Abhinandan, it depends on your grasping ability. It depends on your retaining ability. Okay. If your retaining ability and your catching ability is good, you study 4 to 5 hours a day. It is enough for you. But if your, you know, retaining ability and understanding capability is low, then you might have to study more than 8 to 10 hours also. Okay. So it depends on your ability, where you are standing, that much time you will have to put in. Achha. First of all, apology that I kind of need a personal advice, sir. Jay, if that advice is related to UPSC preparation, you can feel free to contact Rohit. He will get in touch with me. He'll get you in touch with me and then we can have a word. Okay. Priya Bansal, notes and books will be provided by Elite. Yes, we will be providing. Okay. Manas Kumar Jha, when are weekly tests going to start? Weekly tests will be starting from the coming Sunday.
Okay. Okay, sir.
Okay. Tanishka, polity and political and economics classes kab se shuru hai, sir? 2 months down the line, because in the beginning we will be dealing with subjects which are meant to build your base. Like we've picked up world history first, because we need you to get acquainted with the entire history of the world. Then you will be able to understand concepts of liberty, concepts of democracy, concepts of fraternity, which will be used in various other subjects. World history will also become important for understanding international relations of the present time. Okay, that is why we will be going with our methodology. Polity will come 2 months down the line, somewhere 2 months down the line. We will be picking up social issues, social justice next. After that, international relations. And after that, polity will come. Mistakes to be avoided while preparation. I have mentioned it in the approaches to the exam. You should do that. You should not do anything apart from that. Okay. New batch is started. Yes, we've just started a new batch. You can join in the present batch. Okay. Can you give the subject wise schedule for the entire duration of the course? Akhil Tulsidas is asking. Yes, definitely. A mail will be coming your way by the end of this week to all those who have registered. Okay. And the entire structure of the course will be given along with number of hours for each course. The sequence will be given to you. Okay. G. Kishore says, how do we get the books, sir? If you want the books in PDF, they will be mailed to you. If you want the books in hard copy, then you'll have to request the counselors. They will be sending you the books in the hard copy. Okay. Also, sir, we are thinking of having a common WhatsApp group. We had discussed the same with Uday sir. Kindly provide your opinion regarding the same. Akhil, WhatsApp group, you guys can form. Okay. I will enable one person from Elite IS, a representative of Elite IS, to be part of that group. Faculties are not meant to be part of that group. You can contact the faculties when you are here in the session. You can ask doubts from them. But our representative will be part of that group. Faculties will not be part of that group. Hereafter 12, separate classes are running. No separate classes are running after 12 because the syllabus is largely 10th based or 11th, 12th based. Okay. So all the students, whether 12th passed or graduates, are attending the same classes. The 12th pass students have an advantage that they are getting an exposure of meeting students who are way elder than their age. No separate classes are running. Okay. So these are your questions on the chat. Anyone who wants to verbally ask a question, there's a hashtag, ghabrao mat, khul ke poocho. You can ask. So no questions. Yes. Priya Bansal is asking, can we have a lecture recording? Yes, we are giving access to the students who have enrolled. The access to lecture recordings will be given by tomorrow morning to all those who have enrolled. ठीक है.
हेलो
हेलो
सर, एनसीईआरटी कितनी थरोली पढ़ना है?
डिपेंड्स कौन से सब्जेक्ट की. जैसे ज्योग्राफी की एनसीईआरटी 11 12th की थरोली पढ़ना है. यू हैव टू रीड द एनसीईआरटीज फॉर ज्योग्राफी फॉर 11 12th थरोली. फॉर हिस्ट्री यू हैव टू रीड थरोली. फॉर पॉलिटी इफ यू डोंट रीड एनसीईआरटीज देन आल्सो इट इज फाइन. ओके. सो whatever subject will be coming your way, we will be letting you know that read the NCERTs of these particular subjects thoroughly. For some subjects, NCERTs and another source are only sufficient, like for geography. Okay.
Sir,
are you answered?
Sir, kitni reading ke baad uski notes banana
hai? आप एक रीडिंग के बाद भी उसके नोट्स बना सकते हो. ठीक है. मेन टॉपिक ये है कि आपको क्लैरिटी होनी चाहिए. ठीक है.
आप
एक रीडिंग के बाद भी बना लो, आप दो रीडिंग के बाद भी बना दो. मेन मुद्दा ये है कि क्लियर हो जाए आपको कॉन्सेप्ट. ठीक है. अगर बिना बनाए भी चलेगा, कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर है तो भी इट्स ओके, इट्स फाइन. बट मेन थिंग इज कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर होना चाहिए.
सर एक और चीज थी कि जैसे एनसीईआरटी के तो नोट्स बना भी लेंगे, लेकिन जो स्टैंडर्ड बुक्स होती है उनके नोट्स बनाना पड़ेंगे.
नहीं, उनके नोट्स आपको टीचर्स बनवाएंगे यहाँ पे. ठीक है. आप बस वो नोट्स और स्टैंडर्ड बुक्स पढ़ लो.
सर कभी कभी ऐसा होता है कि सिर्फ पढ़ने से समझ में नहीं आता जब तक नोट्स नहीं बनाते.
हाँ, अगर आपके साथ ऐसा है कि सिर्फ पढ़ने से समझ में नहीं आता, नोट्स बनाने के बाद ज्यादा क्लैरिटी आती है, तो आपको बनाने पड़ेंगे नोट्स.
जी सर.
ठीक है. यू विल हैव टू पुट इन दैट एफर्ट.
सर इसका सब्स्टिट्यूट बस आपके लेक्चर ही होंगे अगर नोट्स नहीं बनाने तो.
लेक्चर्स में डिक्टेशन होंगे नोट्स के. ठीक है. और जितने भी स्टैंडर्ड सोर्सेज है ना, वो टीचर्स हमारे रेफर करते हैं. जैसे कि पॉलिटी के लिए स्टैंडर्ड सोर्स है एम लक्ष्मीकांत. तो वो जो टीचर्स आपको यहाँ पे नोट्स लिखवाएंगे वो एम लक्ष्मीकांत से ही लिखवाएंगे. तो यू डोंट नीड टू मेक इट सेपरेटली. Priya Bansal, are you clear on your doubt? Can we have a lecture recording? Yes, you will be having access to the lecture recordings. And those recordings will be valid for lifetime with unlimited views.
Hello, good evening, sir.
Sir, can we start prelim classes?
See, prelims classes are not separate. We will be starting with social issues, social justice. Those topics are also asked in prelims. Then after that, we will be going for international relations, then polity. So, technically speaking, polity se aapki prelims classes start hongi, but wo bhi prelims kam mains hogi polity ki, kyunki polity prelims mein bhi hai, mains mein bhi hai. So, don't go for this separate approach of prelims and mains. Go for the holistic approach.
Okay, sir.
Hello, good evening, sir.
Good evening, Shadab. जैसे पॉलिटी के लिए आप लक्ष्मीकांत पढ़ोगे, आप हमारे टीचर्स के नोट्स रेफर करोगे, बहुत है. ठीक है. ज्योग्राफी के लिए मैटर करती है. ठीक है. और आपको हिस्ट्री के लिए मैटर करती है. ठीक है. जनरल साइंस के लिए मैटर करती है, साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी के लिए नहीं करती है. तो जैसे जैसे जो जो सब्जेक्ट आता जाएगा, वी विल लेट यू नो कि इनकी एनसीईआरटी पढ़ो, इनकी मत पढ़ो.
यस सर.
ठीक है. नेक्स्ट, अभिनंदन, डू मंथली मैगजीन्स आर इंपॉर्टेंट आफ्टर रीडिंग न्यूज़पेपर्स? यस, डेफिनेटली दे आर इंपॉर्टेंट आफ्टर रीडिंग न्यूज़पेपर्स, बट रीडिंग न्यूज़पेपर्स शुड बी द फर्स्ट स्टेप for current affairs, and rest other steps, whether you watch analytical videos, current affairs analysis videos on YouTube, or you read monthly magazines, those are all secondary. Main is reading the newspaper. That will develop your understanding about the topic. That will develop your vocabulary as well. So a lot of benefits of reading the newspapers. All the sincere students who get selected
one thing is common that they read the newspapers, they do not compromise on that.
Okay.
G. Kishore, is there commerce related subject taken in optional, sir? No. No commerce related subject. But there is one teacher in Delhi who specifically deals with commerce and accountancy optional subject only. You can take it there. One of our selected students, Keshav Goyal, who secured rank 324 in his very first attempt. He is a qualified chartered accountant. He did his GS preparation from us and the commerce and accountancy preparation from that institute. We can get you in touch with our selected student as well, Keshav Goyal.
Okay. Hello, sir.
Sivan, is there any faculty for electrical
engineering? No. Electrical engineering's faculty will not be available in any of the coaching institutes. It is a very less like.
Anjali Kumari, which optional subject has short syllabus?
Sociology is one of them.
Hello, sir. Hello.
Yes.
Hello. Do the coaching provide us Anurag?
Anurag, yes.
Do the coaching provide us monthly?
Yes, please go ahead. Yes, you will be given current affairs magazines. They will be sent to you by email.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Okay. Will we get a hard copy of it?
No hard copies of that, only soft copies.
Okay.
Because we cannot send hard copies every month. It will be practically impossible for us. You can take a printout of those copies. We will be sending you soft copies. We will also be conducting lectures for current affairs regularly. So you can cope up with the lectures as well as a soft copy, which we will be sending you.
Sir, actually, I have this bad habit of asking the common mistakes of aspirants. That's why I asked it.
Don't call it a bad habit. It is a very good habit.
So no bad habit because it doesn't go away.
doesn't go well with?
No, us. It doesn't goes away.
It should not go away. Why should it go away?
Hello. Okay.
G. Kishore. Haan.
Sir, एक और doubt था historical sources related. उसमें जो literary source में जो writers हैं और उनके जो उनके books के name हैं उस सभी याद करने.
नहीं general studies के लिए नहीं है वो याद करने होते हैं. Optional paper में वो याद करने होते हैं. General studies में नहीं याद करने.
Hello sir.
Yes.
Sir, ask question in chat box, please.
Anji, Anjali?
Sir, I asked a question in chat box, please answer.
Which optional subject has short syllabus? हाँ, ये वाला question पूछा था ना, which subject, optional subject has short syllabus?
मैं sociology अगर GS paper में लेते हैं, तो optional के लिए वो कितना helpful होगा?
देखो, sociology, GS paper 1 में social issues है, वो अलग से आपको पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी. जीएस पेपर 2 में सोशल जस्टिस है, यू विल नॉट हैव टू रीड दैट सेपरेटली. जीएस पेपर 3 में इंटरनल सिक्योरिटी है, इकोनॉमिक्स एंड डेवलपमेंटल इश्यूज हैं, वहां पे हेल्प करेगा. थोड़ा बहुत डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट में हेल्प करेगा, वहां पे हेल्प होगी उसकी. जीएस 4 एथिक्स इंटेग्रिटी एप्टीट्यूड, इसमें हेल्प करेगा आपको, ठीक है. और एसए पेपर में हेल्प करेगा. ये सोशियोलॉजी का यूटिलिटी है,
छोटा है ना,
काफी छोटा है उनसे, तो काफी छोटा है. जी किशोर हैज आस्क्ड, शुड वी पे सेपरेटली, जस्ट लेट मी, शुड वी पे सेपरेटली फॉर द मैगजीन? जी किशोर, नो, दैट मैगजीन इज इन्वॉल्वड इन योर सिलेबस, इट इज इंक्लूडेड इन योर सिलेबस. टू बी वेरी क्लियर, वी विल नॉट बी सेंडिंग हार्ड कॉपीज, बट वी विल बी सेंडिंग यू सॉफ्ट कॉपीज. ओके, you will never, matlab we will always be there for your support. It should be logical. Theek hai, hum support se kabhi piche nahi hatenge. Chalo, next question.
Sir, how to tackle the situational questions?
Situational questions like?
Next, I have seen once that former UPSC chairman asked a person that you should propose that please propose this glass of water. Then he proposed that.
They are like, you should be, they are checking your confidence basically there. Okay. And you should be, the presence of mind hona chahiye, you should be confident enough, your temperament should be nice, with a smile on your face, you should do that. Okay. You have to do the basics right. Okay. Kuch fancy nahi karna hai, basic rakhna hai sab kuch. Okay. If you go for doing fancy, you will, you know, kuch galat karoge hi karoge. And they are checking your, this thing, temperament there. Kana Gupta, we have to remember all inscriptions, name and their place of origin. Dekho, Kana, remember karne ke do tarike hote hain. Ek to aap bina dekhe remember kar rahe ho. Theek hai. Ek aapke samne question aaya, jaise ki MCQ aata hai. Aur aapko dekh ke idea ho gaya ki क्या है इंस्क्रिप्शन का. आई वुड से कि इट शुड बी देयर इन योर माइंड, बट इट शुड लाइक, मतलब इफ यू कैन अवॉइड इट डूइंग बाय हार्ट, देन यू शुड, अनलेस एंड अंटिल यू हैव हिस्ट्री ऑप्शनल. ठीक है जी. वेंकट सेवा, हाउ मच ज्योग्राफी ऑप्शनल इज यूज्ड इन जीएस पेपर्स? अगेन जीएस पेपर वन, ज्योग्राफी यू नॉट हैव टू स्टडी. Disaster management and some part of economic geography overlaps with economics. That is it. More questions, please.
Sir, how to prepare notes from a newspaper?
Preparing notes from the newspaper, I would say that is not a good option because we will be giving you the magazines. Those are notes from the newspaper. However, you can prepare notes from editorials from section from the newspaper. By the end of this week, I will be taking that session and I'll be letting you know how to prepare notes from the editorial section only. No need to prepare notes from the entire newspaper because we will be doing it for you.
Okay, sir. Sir, I sent my query into the chat box.
Please resend it because I got logged out and I got, again I came. Sushmita asked, sir, when will we get the notes? Is it after the completion of the subject? No, you will be receiving the notes in this week because in the first week there were a lot of students who were in demo. So this week we will be stabilizing the batch and you will be receiving the notes this week. Jay has asked, sir, I have just passed class 12th and got myself into Sri Venkateshwara College. But sir, I am thinking to do private course, sir. So can you please enlighten me on this? Private course related to what, Jay?
Sir, not regular, like School of Open Learning, sir.
Okay, okay, okay. You got admission into Venki?
Yes, sir.
South Campus?
Yes, sir.
I would suggest that, okay, this one is tricky. I need a bit of time to think over it. And can you get in touch in which, to which counselor you are getting in touch with, Rohit or Monica ma'am?
Sir, both Monica ma'am and Rohit sir, both sir.
Okay.
With more in touch with Rohit sir.
Okay. So give me time till tomorrow morning. I'll just give a thought to it. And because see, Venkateshwara is a good college. Okay, very good college. And going for SOL, I need to have a brief discussion with you. So tomorrow morning, 12 o'clock, you can schedule a call with me. You can request Monica ma'am or Rohit sir. They'll get you in touch with me. Okay?
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, okay. Just don't want to give you an advice which will be harmful for you. Okay. Kana Gupta says, I have completed NCERT of history and learned it. So should I go ahead with standard books or revision the NCERTs more? Kana, I would suggest that if you are going with our course, Elite IAS course, you should be covering the NCERTs of those subjects which are being taught here and go with the pace as we are going. Okay.
if you will be doing other subjects NCERTs and then going to the main subjects course books, there'll be a lot of confusion in your head. Okay, so I request you to go with the pace the course is going if you are enrolling here. If you are not going with the course, you can go ahead with the standard textbooks if NCERTs are clear to you. Okay, there's no point of keeping them revised, keep revising them again and again if they are clear to you. If they are clear to you, go ahead with the main books. If you are going with our course, then go with the pace which we are going. That is a scientifically designed method, and that has benefited a lot of students to clear the examination in their first go. Okay, Anurag, sir, when will the next session on how to read newspaper and make notes? It will be conducted on Friday or Saturday. Okay, the same time, 6 p.m. G. Venkat Shiva has asked, can we go Baiju's IAS Baba for daily current affairs preparation without reading newspaper physically? Not at all. I would not suggest, neither from anyone from Elite IAS would suggest to go for that. You should read the newspapers first and then you can go for any of these sources. These sources are good enough. They are not bad. But if you are bypassing the reading of newspaper, this is harmful for you. You will be very easy at this time, but when you sit to write the examination, you will feel difficulty, very much difficulty, because your competitors, particularly the serious candidates who are appearing for this examination, are reading newspapers diligently every day. Anurag Kumar Singh, the session you will be getting the mail for the session. If you are enrolled in the in our course, you will be getting the mail via our online email ID or the official email ID. Abhinandan has asked, do we read the editorial section only or the full newspaper daily? You read the editorial section daily. You read the newspaper daily, only those parts which are part of your syllabus, nothing more than that. Okay. It is not like you have to read only the editorials. It is that you have to read the entire newspaper. Entire newspaper means those sections which are part of your syllabus. Okay, any more questions? So should we wind up? As I can see that there are no more questions from your end. So I hope the session was fruitful for you guys. I just hope things will be implemented on your end. It is all for your benefit. We there will be with you throughout the journey, but it is you who have to, you know, go through it. And any doubts or any problems related to the coverage of the syllabus or the course are always welcome. Okay, we have a very responsive team. You will be receiving constant, you know, reminders or constant communication from our end. We also expect it from you guys. Okay, so in the end, I would say that happy learning and all the best to you guys. And if any one of you wants to reach me, you can contact the counselors. They can get you in touch with me. Okay.
Okay.
So see you guys. Bye bye. All the best.
Thank you, sir.